Today we're gonna check out a nice linear fill. This is a fill that you can use in different kinds of styles of music. We call this a linear fill because all the notes are actually placed behind each other, like in a line. Even though it could be the tom, the crash, or the kick, but they're not playing together at the same time, but they're playing behind each other. First, we're gonna check out the fill and how to do it. After that, I'm gonna show you the collaboration that I did with Andrew at Prestige Productions. Okay, let's see what we're working with here. Okay, let's break this fill down. This fill is kind of based off of two on the floor and four on the hands. Something like this. So two with a kick and four on the hands. You can even speed that up. And later on you can see you can also change the voice. Instead of doing everything on the snare, you go around the tom. That might be a good place to start. Just practice two on your foot and four on your hands. And I do it with right, left, right, left.
We should feel that.
Yeah. Am I doing it?
Hello. Hello.
Doing this pattern, you can run into a problem. It's two on the foot and four on the hands, and if you see on a bar, in one count, it's four notes in one count for 16 notes. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. But we're playing foot, foot, hand, 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 hand. And then the foot pattern starts again. So the pattern is not evenly over those four counts. But because it's not even, that makes it sound kind of interesting as well. If I would play that pattern straight, on the end, I would end up with a double kick, and then because you know you're going ahead with the beat, the one gonna be on the kick too, so it'll be on the last four notes, gonna be hands, kick, kick, and then you start the one with a kick again. To deal with that unevenness, at the end of the pattern, I add a little kick or do a little snare in between, just to come out smoothly back on the one, because you're always trying to come back right on the beat on the one. Like I said just now, it's based on two kicks and four with the hands. But this pattern actually starts with two hands and then the double kick comes in. Let me show you the whole pattern, just very slow, with starting on the hands. That ending is actually the one of the next beat that's coming up. Let me show you one more time. Like you see, it's all 16 notes behind each other. Actually, it's four groups of four 16 notes behind each other. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm going to break it down and I'll show you the pattern right away within those groups. The first group of four is snare, snare, kick, kick. The second group is snare, snare, tom, tom. By the way, I started everything with the right, left. So it's right, left, right, left, the whole time. You can join up the first group and the second group. So snare, snare, kick, kick, snare, snare, tom, tom. The third group can be kick, kick, tom, snare. The last group is snare, tom, kick, snare. And that one kick and snare is actually to finish off the pattern and come back on the crash. So after that last snare, so it's going to be snare, tom, kick, snare, and then you can crash on the first beat of the, or the first count of the next beat. Okay. Let's put the whole thing, all those four groups behind each other. Doing it really slow is sound kind of strange. Even I get it kind of mixed up, but when you do it more, when you get it sticking correctly, and you do it on a more speed, they will come out nicer. One little thing, if that last kick is kind of bringing you out of balance, you could leave it away and just play extra notes on the hands and then just scratch on the one. You see, you could be creative. I just show you one way you can play it, but there are different ways. You can also turn it around, flip it upside down, whatever you like. What I like to do is kind of kick off the fill, like by putting a kick right before the fill start. Look at this difference. See, by the second run, I put a kick in front of it. You can have it this way. Or you can start it with a kick. Like a little kick to put it to start the fill. So that's what I do in this fill too. I would play the beat and then start with a kick right before you start with a fill. Alright, let me show you how it can sound with a soca beat. And maybe a backbeat. I might try to mix them up to each other. Check out this fill and have fun with it. So this is just a suggestion how you can do it, how it could sound, and experiment, and maybe you can find your own way. Maybe you like to start with the snare first, or start with the thumb first, and then go to the kick, and then do the two and four. Whatever suits you and whatever you like, you might find out something new. To demonstrate how this feel could sound in a song, I did a collaboration with Andrew at Pristine Productions. I did a drum beat. I just did a fill, sent it over to him, and he did his magic, and he put some chords and song and bass and make something nice out of it. So check that out, comment now, and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't done so already, or leave a comment if you have any suggestions.